BP 80 over 60, heart rate 110.
They were held up at gunpoint outside a bank.
Will pushed me out of the way. I was handing over my purse to the guy he shot anyway.
You're gonna stay here, all right? Stay right here.
1, 2, 3.
Will, can you feel your arms and legs?
What do we have?
Single penetrating bullet wound to the abdomen.
Husband and wife report hearing one shot fire.
Has he been persistently hypertensive?
80s, 4 over 62.
Slow roll and check for other wounds.
And three. 1, 2, 3.
Stop, please.
Will, let me know where it hurts.
No exit wound. 3.
The bullet is still inside, sir. What does the bullet rule say, Dr. LeBlanc?
The bullet wound seen on imaging should always be an even number.
LOC is decreasing.
Yep.
Get him some blood and TXA.
Fast positive.
Let's get an AP, abdomen and chest. See if we can find the bullet or fragments.
Let's roll him on 3, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3.
A sec. Will. Ma'am, you can't be in here right now.
Lucy, Will's a fighter, okay? We need to figure out the path the bullet took when it went through his body.
Dr. Bishop, looks like the bullet is lodged against his pancreas.
The best thing you can do for Will right now is to give us space to work. I'll come and explain everything after.
Find out how long O.R. needs for an emergency lap.
On it.
And you're filling the wife in. Get a full medical history.
Copy. Lucy. Will's being prepped for emergency surgery to remove the bullet.
But you said it's been lodged in his abdomen.
Yes, which caused significant bleeding. And the surgeons will be able to tell us if there's damage to his organ just once they take it out. Do you want to sit down? Please.
The guy, he smelled like cigarettes. And at first I thought he was just waiting to use the machine. I just wanted to stop for cash. And if I didn't, none of this would be happening.
Police told us they arrested the shooter.
Now he asked if I was doing okay. He's lying there, bleeding. And he's asking if I'm okay.
You found yourself a good one.
I don't deserve him.
I'm sure that's not true. But Will needs you now. I'd like to ask you a few questions about his medical history. It'll help us treat him. Let's start with medication. Is he taking anything regularly?
Will? Will? You're awake. Oh, thank God. About earlier, I don't...
Don't say anything.
Posturing. Intracranial hemorrhaging. We checked his whole body. There was no sign of head trauma. We're gonna need to intubate, get him to CT. We'll need to repeat his blood work. Can you prep 30 etomidate, 100 sucks?
Got it.
His ion levels were elevated, but within range for a trauma patient with coagulopathy.
What are you thinking? Blood thinners?
Well, if he's on them, he's gotta bleed. Even the slightest bump to his head could trigger hemorrhage. Lucy, you said that Will wasn't taking any medication. Are you sure? Because if there's any chance that he's taking blood thinners, we need to know now.
We haven't been together 5 months. I left him.
Now we are balancing two opposing problems. Will's abdominal injury from the bullet and the brain bleed, which is what caused him to lose consciousness.
Can you fix them?
Individually, yes, but they both require equally emergent surgeries. There are risks either way, but the surgeons will want you to weigh in on who goes first.
They want me to decide.
Well, even if you're separated while legally married, you're still his next of kin.
But you said he was stable.
Blood thinners make your blood less likely to clot, which makes you more susceptible to internal bleeds. There are precautions, but...
But you didn't know. Will's had a tough year. His father had all these heart problems, and I cheated on him. We met up today, and he said he forgave me. that he still loved me. But I didn't say it back. Not until just now when I saw him, and he needed to hear me say it. But it wasn't true.
You can do this.
No. I'm the one that keeps on hurting him. How can I be the one making decisions about his life? You decide.
No, I can walk you through the options, but I can't.
Please.
We'll do this together.
I'm sorry.
Could die and she could just, how could she just walk away?
Listen, it's not our job to make her a stronger person, all right? Did you find out why her husband's on blood thinners?
She didn't know. I think I might, though.
Tell me the OR's ready for him.
Well, neurosurgery and trauma are both seeing their needs are priority, so.
And his wife walked away.
Then I make the call. Between two terrible options. Unless there's a third that I'm not smart enough to see.
Well, actually, there is. Will's father had a heart attack.
So you did get a history?
No, it was more like a confession, but turns out Will does have a family history of heart problems, which may be why he's on blood thinners.
Well, his INR is 2, so he's more likely to be on Coumadin than any of the newer anticoags.
And if we dose him with vitamin K and a prothrombin complex concentrate, then we can reverse his propensity to bleed.
That could buy some time. Neuro could go in, start the craniotomy, relieve the clot, and then trauma can take over and fix the intra-abdo bleed.
Get the surgeons talking to each other. Go.
Hey, I shouldn't have left. It was the wrong thing to do. Things just got so messed up. Is he okay?
He's in surgery. We were able to reverse the effects of the blood thinners and stabilize him for both operations.
So he's going to make it?
It's too soon to tell. But the surgeons felt that the risk was acceptable given the alternative.
Okay, when he wakes up, and when he's ready, I'm going to tell him that he deserves to be with someone who loves him back.
Code blue, OR2. Code blue, OR2.
Wait over here. Everything we could. But in spite of our best effort, Will didn't survive his surgery.
Will's dead?
He fought really hard, Lucy. But in the end, both injuries were just, they were too much for him to handle.
You said he was gonna be okay. How am I supposed to live with things ending this way? I trusted you. And you didn't save him.